Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
Thank you. Please be seated. Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to Dalhousie University Spring Convocation. My name is Kim Brooks. I'm Dalhousie's Acting Provost and Vice President Academic, and I'm going to be guiding us through the ceremonies this morning. I'll ask you to please turn the volumes off your cell phones, but none of your other noises need to be silenced during the ceremonies. Please feel invited to cheer and scream and shout and holler. I'll ask Elder Christmas to come and deliver the traditional Mi'kmaq welcome.
Thank you. Could I ask you to rise, please? I have the honor of saying an opening prayer and welcoming you. Jalida, Bakhtu Priwaligis, Gispasanigiskun. Gisuk, Mariamuksik, Amaliapti, Gispasanigiskun. Ahadikcho, Mariamuksnu, Dantijwein Mudio, Jibukchuk. Hatantijo. And me dio. And my chukud yog is then a mighty dio. I thank the Creator for this beautiful rainy day. I have been praying for rain every time I was up at this podium from Monday to Friday, three times a day. So if he didn't hear me, well, somebody did. And I was talking to a young fellow. He said he finally saw his house, and it wasn't touched. He said, "I never thought it was so big." He said, "It was humongous." Because he looked at it with different eyes, he didn't expect to see anything. But he was. Beyond happy, I think, for him and his two children and his wife. And I thank the Creator for this rain, and I ask the Creator to watch over you while you are here, and when you are driving home, walking home, flying home, He will watch over you. And welcome to Mi'kmaq, welcome to our ancestral home of the Mi'kmaq. And I thank you for being here. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Your child, your friend, your nephew, your niece is here. Don't hold back. Have a nice day. Thank you.
Please be seated. Dalhousie University is located in Mi'kmaq, the ancestral and unceded territory of the Lenook. We are all treaty people. There are three key components to this statement. The first is the acknowledgement that the land Dalhousie sits on is part of Mi'kmaq, the territory of the Lenook. The second is the acknowledgement of the territory as both ancestral and unceded, recognizing that the peace and friendship treaties signed between the British Crown and the Mi'kmaq did not involve surrender of land. Finally, we are all treaty people reflects that the peace and friendship treaties apply to all parties involved, Indigenous and settler alike. At Dalhousie, we continue to work on and build from these critically important relationships and friendships, and we remain committed to the recommendations of the Truth and Reconciliation Report. We recognize that African Nova Scotians are a distinct people whose histories, legacies, and contributions have enriched that part of Mi'kmaq known as Nova Scotia for over 400 years. African Nova Scotians came to this province through enslavement or through fleeing enslavement elsewhere. Having resided in the region for over 400 years, African Nova Scotian contributions to Nova Scotia and Canada began over 150 years before Canada became a country. We're thankful to the Indigenous and African Nova Scotian faculty members, staff, students, administrators, and elders who partner with us in developing and enhancing pathways and admissions guidelines, curriculum, welcoming spaces, and community partnerships. We know that we have much more to do to transform our colonial past to a legacy of inclusive excellence. And thank you everyone here for being so willing to step up for our community over this past week or week and a half. We know it has been a difficult time for so many of you in the audience. I suspect many of you know a little bit about Dean John Newhook. He received his Bachelor of Civil Engineering and his Master's of Applied Science from the Technical University of Nova Scotia, which merged with Dalhousie in 1997, which is just another way of saying he is deeply of Dalhousie. His research is focused on improvements in bridge materials, design, assessment, and operation. He has developed new technologies for structural health and monitoring and has made major contributions to the field of bridge design. He has been elected as a fellow of the Canadian Academy of Engineering. His research expertise has opened myriad doors for him, all exciting, including service as chair of the technical subcommittee for the Canadian Highway Bridge Design Code. You don't laugh because you're engineers and you're like, yeah, that does sound great. And apparently, if you take some of his classes, you get to make little bridges, which seems pretty cool to me. So for John, and for those of you who care about engineering, which is hopefully the mass majority of you since you've spent some time studying engineering, I'm offering this piece of art, which was there. There we go. This is Douglas Walker's A805. The blue and cream palette hints at Dutch ceramics or perhaps Chinese porcelain and leaves us ever glancing at dusk and dawn. A805 became the vista of the entire wall of the Dalhousie Art Gallery in 2012. It showed as part of an exhibition entitled Other Worlds. This is a piece that Walker produced with Dalhousie in mind. It was designed to fit that full wall of the Dalhousie Art Gallery, and so in that way, like John Newhook, it is distinctively ours. And it calls to something bigger than us. It is about other worlds. What can we discover about ourselves and about engineering in particular from this distinguished bridge with its crackle coat formula that connects two comparatively less conspicuous islands? The bridge calls on us to ask more about those islands. What are they doing in this sea? How do the trees' roots take hold? What plants and flowers and bugs call the island home? Are there sea creatures who take shelter in nooks along the shoreline? Are the islands being eroded by waves? The islands dream of the stars above them at night. I think the work dares us to see beyond the bridge with its beautiful symmetry and its shimmering lights and demands that we ask what it is about these islands that the engineer who built the bridge believed was worthy of such a splendid form of connection. I think that A805 asks us to honor islands and their possibilities by building resplendent bridges to connect them. And that is what I hope for you in your careers and personal lives. I'm about to offer a metaphor, and I'm telling you that because you're engineers, and I've worked with some engineers, and you are literal people. So let me start again. That is what I hope for your career and personal lives, that you, as our engineers, discover islands out there, see their magnificence, and know that they demand dazzling bridges. I am excited about your paths, personal and professional, and I know that they are going to hold exceptional things. I am confident that they will be like these bridges and islands, resplendent. We're going to proceed through the presentation of diplomas and degrees, and I want this ceremony, as Elder Christians has... I did do it, Christmas. Somewhere in my mind, those two things are like deeply connected, and the last time he said, you called me Elder Christians and not Elder Christmas, and I was like, I've never done that. To show your enthusiasm and cheer for our newest members of the Dalhousie alumni family, go ahead and use the hashtag DalGrad. As always, convocation is being webcast, so you have the opportunity to watch it again. And for those of you who have families watching from home, please rise and we'll give them a wave. If you're a graduate and you've got family and friends watching at home, please stand. Stand. Let me try it again. Stand. Give them a wave. Okay, I'm going to introduce the platform party to you. You've already met Elder Christmas, who gave the traditional Mi'kmaq welcome. Scott Bryson, our Chancellor. Dr. Frank Harvey, our Acting President and Vice Chancellor. Dr. John Newhook, Dean, Faculty of Engineering. Dr. Mutlu Yüksel, Acting Associate Dean, Faculty of Graduate Studies. Dr. Becca Babcock, Assistant Dean of Student Matters for the Faculty of Arts and Social Sciences and our University Beadle. And Dr. Kyle Toussignant, Assistant Professor in the Civil and Resource Engineering Department and the Convocation Speaker. It's now my pleasure to ask the front row to please take their seats and to invite Acting President and Vice Chancellor of Dalhousie University, Dr. Frank Harvey, to give some opening and welcome remarks.
Chancellor Scott Bryson, VP Academic and Provost Kim Brooks, thank you very much for that opening speech. Thank you. Elder Tom Christmas, thank you, Tom, for that beautiful Mi'kmaq welcome. Very nice. Dean John Newhook, family and friends, members of the academic procession, and of course, our graduates. It is such an honor for me to be serving as Dalhousie's acting president and vice chancellor, and to be here today to celebrate with you and with your families as you graduate today. I want to acknowledge that we are all and continue to be deeply saddened and concerned about the impact of the fires in Tantallon and Hammond's Plains and Shelburne and other areas of the province. We are obviously very hopeful that the rain over the weekend and today is helping, and we know some of the evacuation orders have been rescinded. I am sure I speak on behalf of everyone here and our entire Dalhousie community that our thoughts are with the families who've been forced to evacuate, including many members of our Dalhousie community. I am sure they will continue to face significant challenges as they return to their homes. In some cases, they don't have homes, and we will continue to reach out to our students and our faculty members and our staff to offer whatever assistance we can with respect to accommodations and to offer any other further assistance we can. To our graduates today, congratulations. I can only imagine how many emotions you are processing today. I suspect in some cases a little sadness at the thought of leaving your Dal and Halifax communities and many close friends. For others, I suspect you're feeling joy at the thought of leaving Dal and Halifax and beginning a new career and new programs. And I know all of you are feeling immense gratitude for having so many amazing people here and online watching this ceremony who have supported you along the way. But if you are processing emotions today, I hope you feel immense pride. And I'd like to review some of the reasons why your very hard work deserves to be acknowledged and celebrated. Some of the reasons why you should feel proud, and some of the reasons why we are so proud of you. You've spent hundreds of hours in classes and tutorials and labs. You've read thousands of pages from a wide range of engineering texts and professional journals and articles and research reports. You've written and studied hundreds of pages of notes that you've extracted from all that material. You've completed hundreds of quizzes and midterms and final exams. You've drafted hundreds of pages of papers and reports and other projects. You've solved thousands of assignment problems. You've practiced and delivered dozens of presentations in person and online. You found time to engage in design competitions, engage with local groups and organizations through community service. You earned valuable work experience through experiential learning opportunities, many in co-ops and internships, and you found time to be student leaders in societies, athletics, and extracurricular activities. But what else have you acquired as a direct consequence of the enormous amount of time and effort you've invested over the last 4 to 5 years in your respective programs? And for our graduate students, the additional years of work to receive your graduate and professional degrees. Let's review some of this. Depending on your subfield specializations, you have a comprehensive understanding of engineering principles and theories and practical applications and concepts relevant to electrical, mechanical, civil, chemical, computer, biomedical, environmental, industrial, and mineral resource engineering, and for a few of you, perhaps several of those. You've improved your critical thinking and problem-solving skills to analyze complex problems across one or more of these subfields, to break down these problems into manageable components, gather, interpret, and analyze data, to make informed decisions, develop innovative solutions, make logical judgments to solve some of these engineering puzzles. You've gained technical knowledge and skills related to materials, structures, processes, circuit designs, control systems. You have excellent statistical and quantitative method skills, and you understand scientific principles related to conceptualizing, planning, and implementing innovative designs that address specific constraints. You've applied different design methodologies, and you understand how to meet specific requirements related to functionality, efficiency, sustainability, cost effectiveness, performance, and safety. You've improved your research skills to gather, evaluate, interpret relevant data information from various sources, apply different research methodologies and experimental design frameworks. You've acquired project management and multidisciplinary teamwork skills. You know how to plan, organize, and manage projects, collaborate and understand diverse perspectives, delegate tasks, contribute your expertise towards achieving a project goal. You've set objectives. You can set objectives, estimate resources, meet deadlines, prepare research and project proposals and technical reports, and assess budget constraints and related risks. You have computer literacy in computer-aided design, proficiency in programming skills across multiple languages, and you've acquired skills in coding, simulation, and data analytics. You've improved your technical writing and oral communication skills to clearly and concisely communicate your ideas, your plans, and your findings to technical and non-technical audiences. You have adaptability and change management skills to understand the likely impact of new technologies, changing requirements, and evolving industry trends and needs. And many of you had your first exposure to professional practice through internships and co-op programs, acquired practical industry connections and experience, and demonstrated your ability to apply your knowledge and skills to in a professional setting. You've also demonstrated your preparedness for industry through successful capstone projects, applying your knowledge to solve real-world engineering problems, and you understand professional conduct principles and ethical responsibilities, your responsibility to prioritize public welfare and safety, environmental sustainability, legal, social, ethical implications of engineering projects. You understand professional codes of conduct and regulations and the impact of technology on society. You've acquired sensitivities to cultural differences, and I am certain you all have stronger self-confidence and self-understanding. Any combination of these skills, expertise, experiences, specialized knowledge will be absolutely essential to any path or profession or career or job you ultimately select. These are some of the reasons we're celebrating today. But I also know that as you completed your respective degrees, you spent a good part of your time managing and balancing university commitments, work, family, and social lives, dealing with relationships and social pressures, being away from family and friends, anxieties about your program and the choices with respect to your future, student housing challenges, I suspect, managing your budget, in some cases juggling more than one, possibly two or three jobs to cover tuition. And you had to do all of this while navigating a global pandemic and the transition, so difficult in engineering programs, the transition to online and hybrid learning, and the disorienting effects of that deep sense of isolation. All of this required extraordinary and truly inspiring levels of resilience and perseverance and dedication, and I'm sure many of you had to deal with personal and emotional crises and losses tied to the pandemic. Your graduation today captures in a single moment as you cross the stage the essence of your capacity and your willingness to succeed anywhere by applying the life lessons, the skills, the knowledge, the expertise, the passions, the resilience, and the life choices that you've lived through while completing your degree. These are some of the reasons we're celebrating today. These are some of the reasons your family and your friends, the platform party, other faculty members in engineering, and our entire Dalhousie community are so incredibly proud of you. These are the reasons you inspire us. So please make some noise. Congratulations. Convocation also signifies the transition from being a very successful student to becoming a Dal alumni, joining an international network of over 155,000 Dalhousie graduates who have gone on to make significant differences while serving their communities around the globe. As a university, we obviously take immense pride in the success of our graduates, but we are also fully committed to becoming an even stronger university by building on our promises to our students, our promises to our faculty and researchers, our communities, our ongoing commitments to equity, diversity, and inclusion. Essentially, we're committed to building on our reputation and building on our legacy so that the value of your degree, what it means to have a degree from Dalhousie, will continue to appreciate and grow and expand over time. This is our promise and our commitment to you as alumni of Dalhousie. So thank you for choosing Dal. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of your educational journey. Congratulations on this wonderful achievement. Enjoy this special moment, and please stay in touch. Congratulations. Luis Bateri, who is the chair of our Senate, could not make it here today. She's not feeling well. So I've been asked to take over her script. And the first line says, "Thank you, President Harvey, for that wonderful." So kind. Thank you. Will graduates please rise? Chancellor Bryson, on behalf of the Senate of Dalhousie University, I ask you to confer degrees on those candidates whose names have been approved by Senate.
By virtue of the authority vested in me and in Dalhousie University, I admit to their respective degrees and diplomas with all the rights and privileges and responsibilities appertaining thereto, those candidates who have fulfilled the requirements of that degree and whose names have been approved by the Senate. Admitto vos ad gratum. Hearty congratulations to each and every one of you from all of us, and now go out and make a difference. Well done.
Graduates, please be seated. Thank you.
I'll ask Dr. John Newhook, Dean, Faculty of Engineering, and Dr. Mutlu Yüksel, Acting Associate Dean, Faculty of Graduate Studies, and Jessica Walker, an orator and alum from the Fountain School of Performing Arts, to present the candidates who are here today receiving degrees.
Chancellor Bryson, I am honored to present to you the following candidates on behalf of the Faculty of Engineering, who have fulfilled the requirements for the degree of Bachelor of Engineering. Mohammed Amr Mohammed Samir Abdul Fattah, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Barabo El On, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Miriam Akhtar, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction. Dana Al-Fuzan, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Zaid Alala, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Abdullah Ahmed Al-Sad, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Alan Anthony, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Andrew Douglas Arsenault, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Distinction. Thank you. Adam Amedi Okoin, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Jassiel Janique Austin, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering Cooperative Program. Flavie Belanger-Jones, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering. Jabez Troy Benedict, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction. Adam Kenneth Blair, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. François Joseph Boissonneau, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Abigail Charlotte Boynington, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction, University Medal in Environmental Engineering. Joshua Randall Bradley, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Samuel George Alexander Brown, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Simon Wilfred Burns, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. William Colin Campbell, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Jingun Chen, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Rachel Randy Connors, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Alexandru Matthew David Cormier, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Stuart Ramsey Cooper, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Ryan Edward DeGrucci, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Jared Derrick, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Daniel Petko Geich, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering. Danielle Gasparetto, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Duna Gattani, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Riley David Giffen, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Mock Thirval Amani Girard, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Colton Stewart Graham, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Braden Andrew Groff, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Erin Elizabeth Higgins, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering Cooperative Program. Christian Michael Calvin Hodder, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction, University Medal in Mineral Research. Noah Raymond Brinker Hopkins, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Fauzia Tasneem Hoke, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Haddon Desmond Jones, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Ryan Tompkins Kennedy, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Hannah Korn, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Jared James Kublak, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Distinction. Brian Paul Latimer, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Amelia Mary LeBlanc, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Yiteng Li, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Hannah Nicole Longmire, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Deng Mabil Kot, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Heather Ann McDonald, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering Cooperative Program. Malcolm Stewart McDonald, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction. Carson Andrew McKay, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Grace McKenzie, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Distinction. Luke McMillan, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction. Amber Victoria McNeil, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Okba Manzoor, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Aidan Matthew McFarland, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Ryan Anthony Millen, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Hannah Margaret Morris, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Julia Alexandra Morrison, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Lauren Julia Arsenault Mosier, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Mondair Haroub Mohammed Nasser, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Kieran Patrick O'Grady, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Jack O'Keefe, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Brandon Hai Huang, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering. Taylor Gale Prest, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering Cooperative Program, Distinction. Cameron Stephen Pytel, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Elias Leba Ramia, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Mackenzie Trevor Reigate, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Louis Rendon, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Essex Duran Augustus Richardson, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Thank you. Hamza Saijin, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Jeremy Edward Scallion, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction. Devin David Seals, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Boris Joshua Schneider, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Maria Hunter Shaw, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Scott Andrew Smith, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering Cooperative Program. Ryan Souza, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Jacob Hubert Joseph Splinter, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Marika Annalie Stoll, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Meenakshi Devi Sunasi, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering Cooperative Program. Craig Alexander Sutherland, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Distinction. Thomas Zagarakis, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering Cooperative Program. Samuel William Wade, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction. Abdul Ahmed Wadan, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program. Jasmine Evangeline Wombolt, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering Cooperative Program. Madeline Sarah Whitehouse, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering Cooperative Program, Sexton Distinction, University Medal in Civil Engineering. Kiam Wang, Bachelor of Engineering in Mineral Resource Engineering. Su Ming Yip, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering, Sexton Distinction. Sang Yang Yoon, Bachelor of Engineering in Environmental Engineering Cooperative Program. Rina Ahmed Zibian, Bachelor of Engineering in Civil Engineering. Chancellor Bryson, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Bachelor of Engineering. Chancellor Bryson, I am honored to present to you on behalf of the Faculty of Graduate Studies the following candidates who have fulfilled the requirements for the Master of Applied Science. Teresa Awokor Afi, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Elizabeth Godam Hibert, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Masa Kivan Hossein, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Parisa Kevan Hossein, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Jazer Lara Delera, Master of Applied Science in Environmental Engineering. Nicole Kristen LaRue, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Sadaf Raharbi Manesh, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Ryan Douglas Swinemer, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Kasra Takbiri, Master of Applied Science in Civil Engineering. Chancellor Bryson, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Master of Applied Science. Chancellor Bryson, I am honored to present to you on behalf of the Faculty of Graduate Studies the following candidates who have fulfilled the requirements for the Master of Engineering. Aftab Ahmed, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Fahim Ahmed, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Shadi Mohammed Lafti Ahmed, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Farhan Akhtar, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Vignesh Balakumaraswamy, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Adnan Beg, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Zara Bibi, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Swati Bodapatla, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Vaishnavi Chilara, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Nosenkan Chinwal, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Navit Rajnikant Divani, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Vamsikrishna Gadam, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Tarun Ravisankar Ganta, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Nikita Giri, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Mimsy Gupta, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Shafali Gupta, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Venkata Uday Naiduguram, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Fazil Ahmed Nakim, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Farzan Amiri, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Winjue Ji, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Nan Jiang, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Akhil Babu Jupali, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Anirudh Reddy Kaval, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Venkata Lakshmi Narushma Bhagwara Kandada, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Nitesh Dilep Kaswani, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Habiba Anjum Khatun Khalil, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. MD Anasul Abdi Khan, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Srinivas Kuchipudi, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Finnegan Coomer, Master of Engineering in Environmental Engineering. Raghupratab Lingutla, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Nikhil Madala, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Navid Bashamali, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Amarnath Manikandan, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Jagannathan Rao Maru, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Shoaib Mohammed, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Mohammed Mohsin, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Devanshi Bankesh Nayak, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Payam Narozi, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Santosh Nonan, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Harsh Dashrathbhai Patel, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Meet Kumar Patel, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Rutvik Haresh Kumar Patel, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Iqbal Ashraf Khan Pathan, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Jutimoy Kishore Pal, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Sharatandra Pindala, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Pujaradi Pasati, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Madhuri Manjusha Prasadula, Master of Engineering in Internet Working. Bhargava Sireddiputta, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Mohammed Makbul Mohammed Ayub Qureshi, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Pavitra Rajesh Grena, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Pankaj Ranga, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Jagdish Rathod, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Himanshu Sharma, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Sarabjit Singh Harjit Singh Sardar, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Pavan Raj Siramdas, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Heet Gurang Shah, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Abdul Manan Shaddad, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Aparna Sharma, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Shashank Singh, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Divya Shava, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Sanjay Raj Silmoju, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Tandeep Singh, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Tanvir Singh, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Taranjit Singh, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Sungatha Sivaraj, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Balaji Somasal, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Rajasikar Sri Krishna, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Vikram Sira Moju, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Raul Rajesh Sutar, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Yaksh Rajesh Kumar Takar, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Sridevi Thota, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Deep Dharmendra Varalia, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Rivant Venigala, Master of Engineering in Interworking. Sai Pavan Kumar Vanamala, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Haoyu Wang, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Cindy Wang, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Kuting Yang, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Hansil Najkumar Yogi, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Yuqing Zhang, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Yuqing Zhou, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Chancellor Bryson, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the Master of Engineering.
Chancellor Bryson, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is the highest earned degree awarded by the university, and as such represents the culmination of the candidate's educational achievements. I am pleased to present to you the following candidates who, through thesis and examination,
but first, it's possible we have a few more master's students.
Oh, goodness. I'm so sorry about that. Well, there we go. I'm so sorry, Chancellor. We have a couple more master's students to announce. Rohit Kumar Gundu, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Nagasai Paidi, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Tarun Raj Talichuka, Master of Engineering in Internetworking.
Balaji Vinjamuru, Master of Engineering in Internetworking. Got my papers a little out of order, but Chancellor, I am thrilled to present to you those candidates who have completed the requirements for their Master of Engineering. Thank you so much.
Chancellor Bryson, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy is the highest earned degree awarded by the university, and as such represents the culmination of the candidate's educational achievement. I am pleased to present to you the following candidates who, through thesis and examination, have fulfilled the requirements of the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Chancellor Bryson, the awarding of the PhD degree completes a long cooperation between the student and their thesis advisors. We are pleased in this ceremony also to recognize the supervisor of the doctoral candidate, and we ask the supervisor to stand and present the parchment to the graduate following hooding. Following the awarding of the degree, our newest PhD graduates are asked to join the faculty on stage.
Graham Gagnon, Doctor of, Lindsay Aaron Anderson. I am so sorry, Lindsay, Doctor of Philosophy in Civil Engineering. Chancellor Bryson, this concludes the presentation of candidates who are here today to receive the degree of Doctor of Philosophy.
She's made a hasty exit, but let's thank Jessica Walker. All right, graduates, we've been clapping for you for a while, and yet, look at all your friends and family that are here and watching online. I'm gonna ask you to rise, and please give them the warmest possible thank you you can. Dean Newhook.
I'd like to thank President Harvey and Provost Brooks. I think the enthusiasm they showed when speaking about engineering, we all know they secretly wish they were engineers too. We can find some space in September. I'll even waive the writing requirements if you want to. Chancellor Bryson, members of the university administration, members of the platform party, guests, parents, and students. I am pleased to welcome, actually says welcome to the stage, but Kyle's already on the stage. Welcome to the stage today, Dr. Kyle Tusignant. Dr. Tusignant holds a bachelor, master, and PhD from the University of Toronto in structural engineering. Yay. I've also taught him to work on bridges, so, you know, it's getting better all the time. While he's still early in his career, Kyle has established himself as one of our strongest emerging researchers through scholarship, student supervision, and publication and collaboration. His contributions in research and publications have been recognized by various groups, including the Canadian Institute of Steel Construction, the Structural Engineering Institute, and the Canadian Journal of Civil Engineering. Recently, Dr. Tuzignon and Dr. Jeff Packer from U of T won the Canadian Society for Civil Engineering Kazimierz Zowski Medal, awarded annually for the best paper in surveying, structural engineering, or heavy construction. However, today, I also want to acknowledge Kyle's outstanding contributions to the education of our students. I think some of you actually know Dr. Tuzignon, don't you? Yay. Kyle's overall teaching philosophy is to inspire students to ask questions, seek out problems, and find answers. As an associate professor in the Department of Civil and Resource Engineering, his encouraging, supportive, and approachable teaching styles have helped make his structural engineering courses more accessible and captivating for students. Outside the classroom, Dr. Tuzignon is well known for his dedication to students, making himself routinely available for questions and support. He believes that teaching requires constant practice, improvement, and reflection. Through his time in the Faculty of Engineering, Kyle has made notable improvements in several undergraduate courses, creating new labs, new lectures, assignments, midterms, and exams to improve the flow, pace, and overall experience for our students. In 2018, he spearheaded the construction of a fully funded 9-foot-tall steel sculpture that helps students better understand how steel shapes are joined to form the framework of our buildings, bridges, and other structures. The teaching aid has provided students with more hands-on learning opportunities and helped enhance the immersive learning environment we are trying to create within the faculty. This year, he earned the distinction as a 2023 winner of the Sexton Award for Teaching Excellence in the faculty. You can cheer again. This award recognizes educators who, through commitment and innovation, have significantly enhanced the quality of teaching and learning within the faculty. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Tuzignon to address the graduating class.
Thank you, Dr. Newhook. Mr. Chancellor, Mr. President, distinguished members of the platform party, parents, friends, and most importantly, graduates. Graduates from civil engineering, you can cheer. Environmental engineering. Mineral engineering. Engineering mathematics. All right, let's try the next one, internetworking. Very good. To all of you, congratulations. So there are times in life like today, convocation, that have a way of making you reflect. And when I was sitting where you are, which wasn't that long ago, I was hard on the heels of my undergraduate degree in civil engineering at the University of Toronto. I was acceptably smart, or so I was told. I was somewhat involved in extracurriculars, though in hindsight not to a large degree, and I thought I should have known by then what exactly I was going to do with the rest of my life. But I didn't. So I did what every lost person, I presume, does when facing a middle midlife crisis. I applied to graduate school. Now looking back, I realize that I applied to graduate school because despite 4 years of painstaking effort, late nights, and long days in my attempt to keep up with the unrelenting demands of an engineering degree, and yes, engineering is hard for everybody, even your professors, I still felt like I had a lot to learn. Who else feels like they have a lot to learn? That's the right answer, so let me go on. 2 years after I applied to grad school, when I finished what would have been my master's degree and what should have been the end of my years spent wandering the halls at U of T, I didn't feel much different. I felt like I still had a lot to learn. So what did I do then? Yes, a PhD. So logically, you can see how this is not a sales pitch for higher education, even though I do attribute much of my success, if you can call it that, to my own journey through higher ed. But yes, I did a PhD, and at the end of that, I felt not much different. I felt like I still had a lot to learn. And I did then, and I still do now. And there's a lesson in that, that no matter where your journey takes you, you will always feel like you have a lot to learn, and you always will have a lot to learn. So I think it's pretty obvious by now that I'm not an inspirational speaker. But nonetheless, it is an honor and privilege to be up here today to address you. So at the ripe old age of 33, I'm going to try to inspire you with three life lessons I've learned to make a life worth living. Ready? Lesson one, be a lifelong learner. Learn to enjoy learning. Some of you already have, and that's great. If you haven't, learn to play an instrument. Learn a new sport. Pick up piano in your 70s, like my soon-to-be father-in-law. Start taking golf lessons in your 30s. Not sure who that one's about. Don't just do these things for credentials. Do them for the joy of learning. Learning is good for your brain. It's good for your mental well-being and for your self-esteem. So lesson one is never stop learning. Lesson two, be weary of long-term plans. Yes, you heard me. Be weary of long-term plans. What is that about? You should absolutely work passionately and hard in your pursuit of short-term goals. Strive to be micro-ambitious. But keep in mind, you never know where you might wind up. Your next 50 years could be predictable and, frankly, boring. Or they could be 50 years of excitement, opportunity, and adventure. If you become focused too far ahead, you will undoubtedly miss out on opportunities that appear right under your nose or in your periphery. So be wary of long-term plans. Third lesson, be a teacher. Every lifelong learner needs a teacher, so give back, be a teacher. And even if you don't become a teacher with a capital T or a professor, be a teacher. I may be biased, but teachers are the most admirable people in the world. There are no engineers without teachers. There are no doctors without teachers. There are no plumbers, electricians, or welders without teachers. So be a teacher. The world needs teachers. Okay, back to my story. So if you ask me how I got here, and just for context, that's here as in the Steele Professor at Dalhousie, as many of you know me, in the Civil and Resource Engineering Department, I could tell you that from a young age I was into building things, that my grandfather worked in a steel mill, that my mother was a teacher, that I had some talent in math and physics, and that a university degree in civil engineering and a job as a professor was an obvious choice, putting aside the extremely low success rate of that career path. But the truth is that I lucked into the engineering program at U of T. I coasted off my high marks on music, not math or science. I wandered my way into grad school, as you all now know, and I was picked off the floor by an incredible teacher, my PhD supervisor, who helped me grow. I said yes to the right things, which had a way of appearing under my nose, and at the end of all that, I just happened to be in the right place at the right time when Dalhousie went looking, and I lucked out again. So I can't take credit for my success. Nothing about my journey was ever consciously planned or thought out. Yes, I had a few ideas and some micro-ambitions, but truthfully, I've just done what felt right in each moment and tried to make the best decision I could at every fork in the road. The world that you're graduating into today is very different than the one that I graduated into, and in 10 years it will be different again. So don't put pressure on yourself like I did to have it all figured out. It's impossible to know where life is going to take you. Life brought me to Halifax, to Dalhousie. When I was in your shoes, I would never have imagined that. I would never have imagined how lucky I could be. Graduates, you're at the start of what I hope will be a life and a career filled with excitement, opportunity, and adventure. And while you might still feel like you have a lot to learn, I assure you, you are prepared. May your journey be filled with purpose and fulfillment, and may you never lose sight of what truly matters, and that is building a life worth living. Mr. Chancellor, Mr. President, distinguished members of the Platform Party, parents and friends, please join me in congratulating our graduates again, the class of 2023, on everything they have accomplished and everything they will accomplish. Congratulations.
friends, our time this morning is drawing to a close. Graduates, as you leave the auditorium, you'll find members of our Alumni Association standing at the door with a Dalhousie pin. I hope you will wear it with pride, and that when you look at it, you'll remember the time we got to spend together this morning celebrating you. I'm going to invite Maddie Mattson and Chloe Dion, Dalhousie Voice students, to come up and lead us in singing the national anthem. As they do that, I'll ask you to please rise and stay standing until the platform party has left the auditorium.
much good, Maui done it. Get me dead in my net, Don Wetterbeck sold in. Make much good, I will hold my doot in net. Hey, I will hold my doot in net, Don Giso Kelly Galu.
Hey, oh, hey, hi, hi, hi.